Hello, folks. Today I would like to talk to you about how it's necessary in order to break up that we first break down. And what I mean by this is that we are moving to a wonderful new era of humanity. It might be a little hard to believe that currently, but it is true. But first of all, we have to break down all old systems. This means to demanifest them, deconstruct them. And let me talk about what this means both individually and collectively, because we are a cell in the body whole of humanity. And so whatever's affecting the earth is affecting the collective of humanity and is affecting us personally, because we are a cell in the body of the whole. So first of all, physically, we can see that we are evolving. There are various genes that are actually changing in us currently, and the coronavirus is helping us to do that. It is actually triggering our immune system so that we can move to higher frequencies. But first of all, we have become immune to the old frequency that we were living in. And this old frequency are the old structures, the old way of doing business based on greed and profit rather than philanthropy. It's the old way of doing healthcare, which is based on curative rather than preventative. It's based on the old ways of governing, which is based on top-down hierarchies of one person tells all the others how to do it, and all those other followers follow suit and obey, as opposed to really what democracy is, which is a rule by the people, which is a general consensus where all people decide what we want. We all want, in the new system, recycling of everything. What do we also want? We want a safe world environmentally. That means clean air. It means wonderful healthcare systems based on prevention and eating organic foods, not GMO foods. Eating things that are good for our health, breathing air that's good for us, drinking water that is safe. It is the very simple things that are actually what we are going to find are important to move to the new way of being. And you may say, my God, this is the way it was 100 years ago. Not so. 100 years ago, we had terrible illnesses like typhoid and typhus and tuberculosis that killed people. So it's not that it was so wonderful 100 years ago and that we're going back there. No, we've come a long way in 100 years. We've become a global community. We are actually having fewer wars, although it may not look that way because whatever wars we have are more devastating. But most of us would say that we are moving to a period where we have to do this as a global community, and collectively we need to have peace. So we're going through a difficult, let's call it a dark time. And this is the breakdown, but I'm hoping that you can see that out of this we are going to go to the new era. And what can each of us do? Each of us can embrace these new ideas of prevention. So we're washing our hands, we are not socializing. This is preventing us from getting ill, if possible. And meanwhile, we're meditating, we're erasing our old thought forms, the old ways in which we're stuck. The fears that hold us back, that we won't have enough. The fear of dying is what a lot of us are facing currently, or the fear that our loved ones are going to be ill. So we need to become fearless. Fearless and realize that this is just the ending of an era. And whenever an era ends, it is a difficult time. It was with the Roman Empire, it was with the Egyptians, it certainly was with the Atlanteans. And so we're going through a collapse of old systems, but this is breaking down is leading to breaking up the stagnation, breaking up the status quo. And the young people are leading us into this, such as Greta Thunberg, because they're not invested in the old system. And so we have to look at how are we invested in the old system? What are we clinging to? Are we clinging to our money? Are we clinging to hoarding old things? Are we clinging to old ways of being? Anything that we cling to needs to be demanifested at this point so that we can move to the new way of being, the new era for collective humanity. So I wish you well on this spring day, and bye for now.